Tell one homework. Hi, I need to find a formula for the nth derivative of x times cosine x. Okay, let's have a look. So you did the first five derivatives, and I'm pretty sure that we can see a pattern here. And the hardest part is, how do we write a formula for the nth derivative, right? So let's have a look. Right here, notice that, okay, it's x times cosine x to begin with, but if you look at these parts, they don't have the x, but instead they have like what? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And these two are negative, right? So what I'm going to do first is I'm just going to put down a 1 here. And in fact, we can go back here and say that's y parentheses 0. The 0's derivative is just the function itself. And I'm going to move this over to here. And then I'm going to purposely write down 0 times. Well, if you think about it, what would this be? We have cosine that's positive, that matches with this positive cosine, right? So the previous one is positive sine, so we must have 0 times sine x right here. And then plus, right? Because it's 2 negative and then 2 plus and then 2 negative and 2 plus and all that. And then I'm going to put down the one, the numbers right here in red, right here. All right, so now here we go. I'm going to first just write down, okay, if you have y of n, it must be an n right here. And then the hardest part is the function part, right? And of course, we can see that the second term, they all have the x. So we can also put that down to get it ready. So now, here is what we have to do. Let's just focus on this part first. So we have to get to sine x, and then cosine x, and then negative sine x, and then negative cosine x. And then so on, so on, so on, right? So that is what we have to do. And in fact, because it repeats every 4 times, you can see that going from here to here, right? From 0 to 3, and then from this to this, right? It's every 4 times. This is like a block. You can also look at this as like a block. It repeats every 4 times. So if I want to write a formula, you can use, of course, we're doing sine cosine already, but you can use sine cosine again. It's like going around the unit circle. 360 degrees divided by 4, 2 pi radians divided by 4. You should be focusing on pi over 2, right? Because that's you cut into the unit circle into 4 pieces. So let's have a look. So here is our unit circle. Now, this is what I would like to do. I'm going to just consider this point here. This point, though, we have what? Cosine of the angle. I don't want to use x because it might be confusing. Cosine of the angle, comma, sine of the angle, right? This is the x value, and this is the y value on the unit circle. So if we focus on the y coordinate, then we are talking about the sine x. Yeah, that's good. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to rotate 90 degrees. Sorry, pi over 2 radians. So what I'm going to get is a place like right here, like this. Right, 90 degrees. And what's going to happen is that the x value here, that's why I didn't want to use x, right? Because this is the x value, right, from here to here. The x value here will become the y value here at this point. So we will have cosine theta. And this is positive, this is still positive. This is the y value, which is this much. When you rotate 90 degrees, you will see that it becomes here. The y value becomes the x value, but we are on the left-hand side, so this becomes negative sine theta, like so. Pretty cool, huh? Now, let's keep rotating. By the way, if you match the y coordinate here, we have sine theta and then cosine theta. And then if you keep rotating, let's get to here now. Well, this point is just the negative version of this and also the negative version of that, right? Because this is the x value, you go to the other side, right? You flip it to the other side. So you will have negative cosine theta and also negative sine theta. Guess what? Sine theta, cosine theta, and then negative sine theta right here. Of course, we are using theta here and then this is x, but same idea. And lastly, if you rotate to here, right, 90 degrees one more time, this becomes the negative of that, right? So we will have positive sine theta and then negative cosine theta. So to describe this pattern, we can just look at this, 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 that. And the key is you start with sine theta. Yeah? And then you have whatever the angle is, let's use x now because that's our original input. So x. And then what we want to do is we have to add. We added pi over 2, right? And then 2 pi over 2 and then 3 pi over 2, so on. We have to add n times pi over 2. So for these parts, I'm just going to put this down. And this takes care of the negative already because we were focusing on that too. So we have all that, and then we just have to multiply by sine of x plus n pi over 2, like so. And then we just have to add this with. Now, if we start with cosine, we just have to look at this, 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 that. Very beautiful, right? It's just cosine and the negative sine, and then negative cosine, and then positive sine. So it's just cosine, the cosine version, and x plus n pi over 2. So this is how you can get a formula for the nth derivative of x times cosine x. And of course, you can also write it as like a piecewise definition. You get this, right, or the 5, like this, with the cosine here, and then the negative sign here. When n is, when you do n divided by 4, and the remainder is 1. And this is when you divide it by 4, you get remainder 2, remainder 3, remainder 4. But that's piecewise. This is much cooler.